Have you ever seen a movie and thought to yourself, that looked amazing? Like, the way they were shot, the way everything looked, it just looked beautiful to you? Well, what I'm going to present is my Pentax M Super. It's a film camera. So it's a tech camera that you open up, you lower it with film. And the reason I believe I'm able to talk about this is because I'm currently taking a photography course here in Cal State, and also I'm going to be serving as a cameraman for my friend's short film that we hope to be shooting in a few weeks. And I think by me explaining this, you will have a greater understanding of how the cinematography, which is what this is called, will help you get a better idea of how what they do affects how you experience the movie. And my points I will discuss will be how they what they do, how it changes your experience, and how I identify with it. To me, like I said, it represents my experience, my interest in cinematography. And most films, before the year 2000, were shot and projected on film. Today, most of them, though, are shot on and projected digitally. And also, when you're using cameras and stuff, you have to make sure you're getting the proper exposure to make sure that nothing comes out too bright or too dark. It comes out the way you want it to. I'm pretty sure most of you have heard of the movie called Revenant. It's the movie with Leonardo DiCaprio when he gets attacked by a bear and stuff. Well, the cinematographer for that movie, his name is Emil Lubezki. He is well known for using long shots that just keep going on and on, and using natural light, so like, he would use mostly lighting that he gets from the sun. He wouldn't bring in a light and light a set like that. Well, The Revenant, what made it so special was because of the way he lit it. Yeah, most movies, they use a lighting setup. And what he did with that movie by doing that was kind of making it more realistic. And if you guys remember, for those of you who have seen the movie or the trailer, you'll remember that bear attack. Well, that scene was shot in one shot. It doesn't cut or anything. What that does is it kind of gets you, it puts you into the scene with him. You're kind of experiencing what he would experience. Well, the reason I identify with this culture is because as a kid, I always went to the movies. Like every weekend with my family, I would go. Eventually, when I got around into middle school and high school, I started meeting people that also had those shirts in the movies with films. And we just eventually got together and would talk about them. We eventually decided we would want to make one. Well, we eventually did make one in high school, but that came out really awful. It was terrible, badly shot. The actors were really bad. Well, as I said, as I got into movies, I started learning about all the different people that would work on the movies, the directors, the writers, the actors, the DPs, which is the cinematographer. And one of the things when you're trying to learn cinematography, one of the things they'll tell you about how to learn is to imitate your favorite movies, the way they look and everything. Another thing that we're going to be doing with my friend, like I said, we're going to be making another short, hopefully in the next few weeks. Well, they decided I will be the cameraman for that movie. Well, short. So yeah, to conclude, hopefully at this point you kind of got a better understanding of how the work that cinematographer does kind of affects